We're back for a lads' weekend, yeah, in the very unknown provincial capital of Soria. Most people, when we've said they're going to Soria, don't really get it, or they go to the province, like, no, the tiny, I think it's the second smallest provincial capital out here in Castilla y León in the east, on the banks of the river Duero. Spoiler alert, there's going to be red wine. I've got quite a lot of old books, one from the 1880s, a little guidebook, which says this is quite an attractive medieval walled town with a population of 6,000 people. Then I've got another one from 1901, which gave it two lines and said it was on a barren wasteland, population 6,600. Then I've got a book from 1932, which again actually extols how attractive the little old town is and had a population of 8,000. Today, 2024, 39,000. So it's not very big, but we're gonna eat and drink way too much as per usual. We got here quite early. Fancy some breakfast?
Yes.
Okay. In a mad bar, everyone in the city's here. We're having a mid-morning breakfast at 11:40. I don't know if you can hear this. Everyone's in here. We've got these things called tortas, which are these big, kind of like very olive oil heavy bread sandwiches. We have the vegetal, the vegetable one, which has also got ham, it's also ham, tuna and egg in it. There's the vegetable one. Then we have one called picadillo, which has got like chorizo meat, tomatoes and cheese in it. So we've been in Soria about 10 minutes and we're starting to eat.
We're open today.
We are now in the Alameda Park. The piece here could not be more different from that insane bar. We've got a few hours before we check in to our automated hostel. So then we're going to stroll around a little bit, have some nibbles, enjoy a relaxed pace. Now, Steve's a fan of an esplanade. How is this meeting your expectations?
I'm not sure.
It's got good length.
The length is not the problem. Most esplanades are skirted by topiary.
There are trees.
Yeah, but not topiary.
Okay.
You see, that's different. Good bench ratio. I like that.
Hefty bench ratio.
But they look very splintery.
Okay, that's this is dragging on.
A bit of sanding would do wonders, I think.
Out of 10?
Yeah, 6.
We'll take it. Right, the presence of churches and nice... You're upping your score for the esplanade.
Look, the benches still very... need to be sanded. But okay. We got churches, storks, kiosks for drinks. 7.5.
We're getting there, guys. So while crazy music plays in the background through the park, we're going to go to El Kiosco, which is kiosk, which is a little bar, and have our first beer of Soria to break the ice because it's gone past midday now. So, as I wipe beer off my face, we've only been in two bars. I'm noticing something, which I noticed last time I was in the Soria region, because of the proximity, I think, to La Rioja and Navarra, and therefore, by extension, the Basque country. A lot of these bars, I think we're gonna see lots of pinchos, those kind of Basque-style things, things on bread, lined up on the bars, even though we're in Castilla y León, not too far from La Rioja, Logroño being the next stop on the bus. Anyway, from us in the park, salud. Shout out for Laura, who mentioned that Soria does kind of sweet and they're famous for their butter. Gracias. Drinking Tiesto. Tiesto is what the locals here call Mistela. He takes fortified sweet Moscatel wine, blends it with white wine, probably Rebecca, and you serve it these little cups. Mm.
this bar could not be any more basic. Their menu is mushrooms, skewers. Oh, they've got kidneys, rignones. Let's try some kidneys.
Brief moment between the music. So today is the verbena, which is one of the local parties in Soria. There seems to be a lot of local musical groups get together, play a lot of music, parade through the streets. It's not a virgin or a saint or anything like that. We've ordered some middle mushroom tapas. I've ordered a kidney tapa. And Steve ordered something called a cojonudo. We'll show you these when they come. But yeah, it's a lot of life for a town which, you know, 100 years ago had 6,000 people in it.
I want to try my kidneys. This is going to end in chaos, I think. Good. Really good.
Welcome to the complicated mushroom challenge. So we got bacon, garlicky mushrooms. I mean, it's mushrooms, and we're in Soria. It's kind of their thing.
Grab a little bit of that.
Are they crunchy, Steve? They're supposed to be crunchy. I think they sound crunchy. Are they crunchy?
It's like crispy bacon.
No.
Right, crispy torreznos, the crispy pork rind's done. Now we're heading down towards the main square. We're going to try, hopefully, the OG style. So this is the classic style, award-winning torreznos. Steve, grab a good piece and see what we think. It's meaty. Is that good? Yeah? So we've got a few things in classical. So I want to try the torretno you've had. Hang on, let me put my hands. I mean, that style is better. Wow. They have a little award-winning tapa of artichokes, wild mushrooms, and a truffle in a cream. That's nice. Right, the tigre, oh, by the way, bravas. The tigre is a mussel shell, and they make like almost like a croquette mix, a bechamel, mix it with stuff, put it back in the mussel shell, bread it, and then fry it.
But this is not going to be a trip to the hospital in terms of feet.
Hopefully not. Yeah?
Yeah.
Right, we're about to check in. We're going to try and get one more cheeky glass of wine in a bar called Libro de Vini, or Libro de Vino, which actually has a legit wine selection. All right, we're going to do our check-in. We're going to do our check-in now. Amazing little bar. The lady was wonderful, Asuncion. What a great little bar. Now we're going to check into our hotel. Have a little siesta, family. Right, quite groggy. We're back out in the hunt for Romanesque churches for more food.
The San Juan de Rabanera. The usual entrance into a horticultural space.
It's quite charming. It's like they're squeezing in these massive religious buildings, convents here, convents there, wherever they can fit in these small streets.
The man with the beer has arrived. Thank you, sir. Yeah.
Little aperitivo stop before dinner, the gastro tasquita.
Cheers.
Wow. Wild boar cheeks.
Another absolutely happening bar, that one. Wonderful little place. Chaotic but very friendly. The prices. A lot of people actually ask us when we do these videos, like, how much did you spend? I can't remember. But all I can say was a massive glass of draft Alhambra Roja Reserva beer was €1.90.
Volcano potatoes. Let's have a little try of these. Loads of sauces, loads of cheese.
Yeah, good.
Mmm.
Oh, yeah.
Nice burger.
Right. Very full. Lovely burger. Very nice chips. Right, we had a little cheeky wine in the terrace bar below our hotel, and now we're going to try and do maybe one more little stop on our very long day. I think it's called Underground Rock Bar. Good morning. Did I sleep well? I did not. For the fiestas. Do I have a hairdryer in the room? I do not. Do I have wet hair? I do. Are we having breakfast? We are. We are on a little terraza just having your classic coffee, pinch of the tortilla, at a cool little place called Antigua Casa Apolonia. What's our plan? Well, we're going to do some tourist shopping because we need magnets, right, Steve?
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to do a route along the river Duero. So yesterday was all food. Today there will be food, but today we want to get out of the city centre and do a little route and see some amazing churches along possibly one of Spain's most important rivers, especially if we're talking wine. So, from me and my ibuprofen, salud. Right, it's worth mentioning Numantia, which is currently a very impressive ruined Celtiberian settlement about, I think, 10 kilometers north of here, which we won't have time to visit, sadly. But the Celtiberians were basically the people who, the Iberians were here before the Romans, everyone got here, and the Celts were also here before these other people got in, and the Celtiberians were the interbreeding of these two peoples. And the Romans came in, and Romans were not a big fan of getting along with their neighbors. They started to lay siege to these settlements and essentially get rid of everyone. So Numantia was famous for holding out for a long time, like a heroic last stand against the Romans. I think it was in 100 and something BC. I can flash the real date up now. And apparently even in Spanish, to say a siege of Numantia is to kind of fight the good fight for as long as you can. So hopefully if it's open, there is the Numantine Museum. We'll have some nice artifacts and stuff because the town is clearly very proud of its Numantian heritage. Right, nice little museum there, and it was free, I think, because it was Sunday. It's usually just €1. A lot of pots, a lot of cups, a lot of earthenware, but we did see the symbol of the city, the little iron brooch with the horse. So we're walking quite literally out of town. You can see the distances over there, Soria. And we're going to a wonderful shrine up on a hill. And that is, we dip down the other side and we join the Duero River for our pre-lunch walk. So we are arriving at the hilltop shrine of Our Lady of Miron, and it is beautiful. You've got the whole city around you, Soria. Keep surprising. I mentioned that some of those early descriptions of
Soria mentioned it is a medieval walled town, but today if you're in Soria, you're not going to notice that. However, if you come out to the fringes or the limits of Soria, as we are now, you can find remains of the medieval wall. Right, we're now approaching one of their other sort of poster child monasteries, churches called San Juan de Duero, which is a very original name, St. John of the Duero. And this one's famous for its beautifully kind of conserved open, it's ruined, but arches of their cloister. It's really quite beautiful. I also read that in one of these old guidebooks, they said that Salamanca, out in the west from Madrid, is the golden city, and on days when the sun shines, this is the red city. So we're walking on the beautiful banks of the River Duero. There's two more monasterios, santuarios along this route. One is called San Polo, which as far as I've understood is now in private hands, but I think you can still see it. And the other one is San Saturio, which has got a very impressive kind of cliffside location. Estos perritos, hello. Hello, boy. I can't reach you, you're too far away. And your friend, Wapo. All right, we made it. I'm gonna go inside. Into a cave, and then suddenly you leave the cave. And you're in a church. Cave. Modern building. It's raining a wee bit. Fortunately, we're really far from cover, so. We're donning our protective gear and brollies. We're gonna head back now towards Soria along the river. Maybe find somewhere to eat. I'm gonna have a glass of vino. So we've got our beers. And I ordered Torreznos. Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. Idyllic on the left and then ridiculous massive shrimp on the right. Pork loin fillets in a cheese sauce. Mm-hmm. Mm. Then we got nachos because nachos. You join us here for the stunning wet denouement. We have a very, let's be honest, average little lunch. We're drinking nice average Ribera del Duero wine. And it's raining. Yeah. Enjoying the weather, Steve? Ah! Now we're walking to the final part of this incredible, amazing, illuminating video in this wonderful little city of Soria, which is a Jesus statue, some remains of a castle and a viewpoint. Clearly doing a pretty good job of updating the scant remains they have to create obviously a kind of a castle park, which is very nice.
What do you think, Steve?
So what will likely be our last stop of the trip? The Parador, modern Parador of Soria, up on a hill. A storm started blowing, so we've come on in. I've ordered a coffee and a what they call a lazo of Soria, which is a soft braided pastry. Let's have a little taste. Very simple, very nice. We'll have this, head back down to the center, and put a full stop on the story of Soria. Come down off the heights from the Parador. We bring an end to our little trip to Soria. So we're gonna head back to the bus now and head back to Madrid.
Did you have fun?
Not really, no, no. Should people visit here?
Maybe. You have to. Like a wedding or something.
What if the Soria City sort of Council watches this? Yes, you should come to Soria. It's a very nice.
They're not watching
this. Very nice little town, has a bit of everything, and very cheap and affordable if you want a nice foodie boozy weekend. So anyway, from us in Soria, I'll press all the buttons. I guess if you want to see Steve again, give us a like and a subscribe. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye.